In late 1957, Lockheed began developing a follow-up to the Lockheed U-2, an aircraft to overfly the Soviet Union. The designs became known as Archangel, and a number of evolving designs were produced. This eventually was developed into the Archangel 12 design, the A-12. The CIA program to develop the follow-on aircraft to the U-2 was codenamed Oxcart. It was a codename that frequently would be used for the aircraft, although the crews named the A-12 the Cygnus. Many new technologies had to be invented for the Oxcart project. One of these was working with titanium. Titanium was only available in limited supply, and the CIA had to conduct a worldwide search for the quantities needed. A large part of the material was bought through dummy corporations from the world's leading exporter, which happened to be the Soviet Union. The A-12 was constructed mainly of titanium, and it was a difficult material to work with. Various new radar-absorbing composite materials were also used, combined with asbestos, to make the aircraft more stealthy. The first test flight was taken at the Groom Lake Test Facility in secret, April 25, 1962. The official first flight took place 5 days later. The first versions had Pratt & Whitney J-75 engines, making the aircraft capable of reaching Mach 2. The J-75s were soon replaced with newly developed J-58 engines, which made the A-12 reach speeds of Mach 3.2. In 1963, a test aircraft crashed. The pilot ejected safely. The official story was that a Republic F-105 Thunderchief had crashed, and nearby farmers were told it was carrying atomic weapons, to keep anyone from examining the crash site. Three more A-12s were lost during later testing. One of the pilots was killed, ejecting from his aircraft, but the other two managed to eject safely. The A-12 was designed to replace the U-2 for flights over the Soviet Union and Cuba, but it was never used for this purpose. After a U-2 was shot down over the Soviet Union in 1962, it was considered too dangerous to conduct flights over the country. It was also no longer necessary, since reconnaissance satellites had been introduced. U-2s continued to be adequate for flights over Cuba. Instead, the A-12 was used in Asia, flying reconnaissance missions over North Vietnam. The A-12s operated from Kadena Air Base on Okinawa, and on their way to North Vietnam they sometimes intruded into Chinese airspace. During the Vietnam missions, the Soviet-constructed SAM sites used by North Vietnam proved to become more and more sophisticated. In 1968, three missions were flown over North Korea. The aim was to discover whether the North Koreans were preparing any large-scale hostile move, following an incident with U.S. Navy intelligence ship Pueblo. In a way, the A-12 was obsolete even before it was put into service. The flights it was intended for were no longer necessary, and Soviet radar systems had increased their capabilities, making the A-12s vulnerable. The A-12 program was ended December 28, 1966, due to budget concerns. Also, the Lockheed SR-71 entered service in March 1968. The 29th and final mission of the A-12 was flown over North Korea on May 8, 1968. A YF-12 interceptor variant was tested, but only three were built before the project was abandoned. A drone variant, the M-21, was also tested, but the project was cancelled in 1966. One variant of the drone, the D-21, was used for a number of missions over China from 1969 to 1971, but the missions were not very successful. When the Lockheed A-12 was retired in 1968, after only 1 year of operational service, 13 aircraft had been built.